All right, ladies, I know it's been a minute since I've put up a video, but I was getting ready for an interview the other day and decided to record what I think my version of an appropriate makeup look would be for a job interview. So let's get started. All right, so the first thing I'm gonna do is prime my eyes. This is a Benefit product. It's a Stay Matte Eye Primer. I'll put it in the description box below. I've already primed my face with my Beautifully Matte number 7 primer. So all that white stuff you see all over my face, that's what it is. I promise I haven't been sucking on powdered donuts at 6 o'clock in the morning. So the first color I'm gonna pick up is a Coastal Scents color, and it's called Harvest Brown. Harvest Brown is very, very close to Brown Script, but it's a little more on the brown side, and Brown Script is a little more on the orangey side. I'll be using Brown Script as well. So I'm gonna pick up Harvest Brown on a Sedona Lace E40 tapered, Sigma E40 tapered blending brush, and that's going right above my crease. And I'm putting on a very light layer. I'm being very light-handed with my eyeshadows. Again, this is for a job interview. I'm not going out for a night out on the town. So the second color I'm going into is my brow bone highlight. And of course, that is Max Rice paper. I'm picking that up on a pointy brush. Don't remember the name of this brush, but that's the brush I always use when I'm applying my brow bone highlight. But I will find out the name of the brush and I'll put it in the description box below. So now that that is on, I'm going to blend those lines out so you don't see where one starts and the other one ends. And before we move on, shall we take a coffee break? I think we should, in my Wonder Woman cup. All right, so the next color I'm going into is Brown Script. Again, it's a close second to Harvest Brown. And Brown Script is going into my crease, and I am using the infamous Crispy method. It really does work. Shout out to Crispy for this method, because it is a godsend. So if you haven't tried it, hold your brush slanted upwards so that the bristles are actually slanted down, and it'll do the blending for you. I'm going into my Naked palette, and I had a difficult time deciding what color I was going to use. I didn't want anything too dark or too bright, so I went with Smog. So I'm gonna pick Smog up on my little El Cheapo $1 Elf eyeshadow brush, and I am applying one layer of this shadow on my lid. Again, you don't want to be too heavy. You don't want to look like you're going out to the club or a date night, or you're going to a concert, or you're in a pageant. This is for a job interview. You also don't want to look like you just graduated from junior high school as well. You know what I'm saying? So you do want to look like a grown woman and feel, you know, beautiful at the same time, but not overly done, is my point. So the next color I'm going into is Embark. And I'm gonna pick that up on a little fluffier brush. This is my version of the 217. This is the Sedona Lace version of it. I forget the number of the brush, but I'll put it in the description box. So I'm gonna focus that color on the outer corner of my eye and drag it halfway into my crease. I'm just trying to create a little bit of depth and definition to my eye. I didn't want it to be so flat, but I'm not going in heavy. I don't want it to be too dramatic. I don't want it to look like a very deep contrast. So just a little bit, not too much. As you can see, I literally dipped my brush in once, one application. I'm going back in a Brown Script, and I'm going to blend out Embark with Brown Script, so that we soften that up so it doesn't look too dark. I think this is a great look for an everyday sort of eye as well. You know, if you don't feel like going into 4 and 5 colors, you just want a basic everyday sort of fall look. I think this is a great look for fall as well. It's quick, it's simple, it's easy, it's 1, 2, 3 and you're done. All right, so I've already used my MAC Prep and Prime in Peach Luster under my eyes and around my mouth. I am now using my favorite Kat Von D foundation. It is now getting cold enough here in Houston to where I can wear this foundation. Up until last week, it was still like 79 degrees, y'all. It was ridiculous, and I was using my NARS Sheer Glow. So I am happy that I can use my Kat Von D. I'm picking that up on my favorite Sedona Lace Flat Top Kabuki Brush. Now that that's on, I am going to highlight under my eyes just a little. It is early in the morning. I do need to look fresh and awake, but I'm not going to be drastic and dramatic with it. I'm literally using one dot on my Beauty Blender sponge. I did wet it with Fix Plus. You see how it's the small amount? So I'm going to apply that under my eyes and blend it out. And that's just going to give me the appearance of, you know, being awake and fresh-faced. Okay, so I am going to contour just a little bit. I'm going to pick it up on my NARS Eater brush that is blunt. One stroke, that's it. Other side, same thing. I only dipped my brush into blunt once. I'm going to do it around my hairline as well as my jawline. Just to bring some more definition and shadows back to my face. I do have a 4, 5, 6 head, so maybe I should have been contouring a little more on my forehead, but. So I'm gonna set my under eye highlight with Laura Mercier. This is a Sedona Lace brush. It's part of their Midnight 7 series. I love this brush. I don't like using a sponge when setting my under eye highlight. I just feel like for me, using a sponge, it kind of settles into fine lines. I am a woman of a certain age, so I do not need those lines to be showing up nowhere, no how. So as you can see, I literally dust it on. And it works great for me. I love using a brush rather than a sponge. I don't like the baking method. It just creates those fine lines for me. One more sip of the coffee. Muy importante. It was like 6 o'clock. All right, so I'm going to take my foundation brush and I'm just going to mute out the highlighter, my concealer that's on my temples. I don't want it to be too strong. If I were going to be using a cheek highlight, I probably would not have muted it as much, but again, this is for a job interview. I'm not going to be using a cheek highlight. The blush I'm going to use has a shimmer to it, so I don't need to use a cheek highlight. So I've already used a liner on my top waterline, and now I'm going in with Urban Decay's Perversion Mascara. I am going to set my entire face with my favorite Ben Nye powder in Nutmeg. I put it in a cap. This is a Sigma fluffy brush, and I literally just dust it over my entire face, even where I've highlighted under my eyes, just to mute it just a little bit. I don't want it to be so bright, but I do want to look awake and refreshed and ready to go. So the blush I chose to go with, it's a MAC blush and it's called Trace Gold. This is an oldie but goodie. So Trace Gold is just that, it's gold, but it's got some iridescence to it, some shimmer to it. It almost has sort of a peachy undertone. So I didn't go in heavy with the blush. Again, this has got little hints of shimmer to it, so I didn't need a cheek highlight. Let me move on to the lippy lip lips. All right, the hair is down, my blouse is on. So I'm gonna line my lips with Nutmeg. I know, not Vino. I know y'all are like, oh my gosh, she's not using Vino. I know, I know. I don't know what's going on, but I needed my lips to be neutral. I didn't want anything too loud or too bold. So I went with good old trusty chestnut. Did I say nutmeg? I meant to say chestnut. If I said nutmeg, I meant chestnut. That's Max Chestnut. I'm looking for my lipstick. Okay, so I'm gonna go in with Max Fresh Brew. Fresh Brew is a great fall color. It is a sheen, not a matte finish, but it's a great, you know, light brown, neutral color, almost kind of sort of blends in to the tone of your lips. And I love the color. As you can see, I love it. So I'm just gonna, you know, reapply some liner on my bottom. My lips are crooked from a sports injury. I hate it. I always have a problem lining my lips. My nails are busted. All right, so let's fluff the hair out. I am all done and ready for my interview. Ladies, wish me luck. Thank you so much for stopping by my channel. I hope you enjoy my tutorial. And until next time, ladies, take care of yourselves and God bless. Bye.